maybe we can use the fuel pump from that tanker.
No, it won't work on this motor.
Mechanical genius.
Oh, man. Oddball, look, I can't make it work without the parts, no matter how positive I think.
Hey, look, Kelly, this guy in the tiger, the least we can do is get him on the radio and talk to him.
You crazy? The guy's got to be a full fanatic freak, otherwise he would have split out of this town 20 minutes ago.
Hey, all this guy is doing is guarding the bank like he was told.
Yeah, maybe. But I wonder if he knows what's in it.
Hi, welcome to Moments with Meaning. And today, we're going to talk about applying Neville Goddard's teachings and how the Bible is saying the same thing in what they tell you. So in Galatians, it is told to you right there that Abraham, Sarah, and Hagar are an allegory. Okay? Hagar represents the objective side, the physical side. And Sarah represents his imaginative side. And he had a baby with both. Okay? Physical babies with Hagar. And then, you know, he was born again. Him and Sarah had a baby. Okay? So, this is, then Paul tells you it's an allegory. You know, right there. Well, if Abraham and Sarah allegory, everything else is an allegory. It's all an allegory. And it has to be an allegory because there's no other way to describe it to the human who God and man are together making a baby. Okay? And man is the Word. And what people get tripped up about is in the beginning. Okay? It means in the beginning of the story. In the beginning. Okay? We had to make a nest. So we did. We made the universe and everything in it. We made this beautiful earth and we put all this stuff in it. You know? This is where our baby's going to sleep. Okay? And we're watching our baby dream. You know, and the baby is the human imagination. And we just do whatever that human imagination wants us to do. Oh, yeah. That's okay. He's going to learn to be the greatest little dragon. He's the best little dragon ever. Have you ever noticed? If you put in a Google search for the most popular symbol, it's a dragon. And right behind that is let's see, one of them was a Merkaba. Well, let me go look. Hang on. Yeah, the Holy Grail. The Holy Grail and the Merkaba. You know, dragon, Holy Grail, Merkaba. Okay. Dragon. We're dragons, individually and collectively. We become a dragon. The human imagination has been tamed. You know? And God and man tamed him. And the human imagination and man and God become one. And the part that is called the Holy Spirit, this is, you know, the love principle. It's divine love. And that's what wraps it all up and binds everything. You know, it's love. So that's the true power, is the attention you give them. You know, in the objective world, because that world is just really nothing. It really means nothing. It's really as much ado about nothing. You know, it's a dream, so you can change it. And if you can get over that hump and know you can do it, which is what Neville Goddard's teachings were all about, you know, believe in yourself. Act as if you were God. You know, trust yourself. Just imagine it. Just assume it. It's yours. You know, and he emphasized throughout he was born again in 1929, and the next 30 years, he spent emphasizing the human imagination. It's the human imagination. You know, if you're going to think anything, err on the side of love. You know, He never talked about positive, negative, and all that. It was err on the side of love. And, you know, act as if you're God. And God is the human imagination. And this was the normal, natural thing to think. Because in the womb, the baby, the human imagination, is in charge. Father has handed the reins over to them and is being whatever they want, you know. And because of the nature of your being, you're going to get slapped if you're not thinking with the divine, okay? So the human is literally fusing with the divine, you know, and the human is the word. So the words have to evolve and the languages have to evolve. And they are a Tower of Babel. It changes from generation to generation. Sick, bad, good, they all mean the same thing to different generations. That's that Tower of Babel. That's the mystery going on. No, you're wrong. Science is saying the same thing as the Bible, as all of it. As Cinderella. And, you know, the second most popular symbol, the Holy Grail. King Arthur and the Holy Grail. That is the story, you know. And he dies from Uther Pendragon, that righteous guy, right? Wants stuff, and he wants to eat grain, and he wants all this. And because he thinks ill of others, he loses the grain. And the child is born between him and a grain. You know, that's the child of imagination. And he, Merlin, takes the baby. This is the baby. This is the one that will be the king. You know, and he shows him. You and the land are one. You and the animals are one. All of y'all are one. It's called the dragon. Okay? You're one with the dragon. So, you know, sleep, dream. And you'll get all these wonderful things. And he does. You know, he does. Then he falls in love, right? And here comes that love part, that divine love. Still thinking good and bad? Still thinking good and bad, baby? And then you overcome that by drinking from the Holy Grail, his 12 nights, the 12 laws of mind. Go out, wrap themselves around him, and bring him the Holy Grail. And all their own adventures. It's the story of Hercules and his 12 challenges. You know, and then he realizes, holy cow, I've always known this. You know, I'm one with the land. I was just looking at it that way. Now I'm going to look at it this way. Let's get drunk. Let's put it on. Let's go have some forgiveness. I forgive you, I forgive you, I forgive you, because I know I made you do it. Sorry about that, Lancelot. Sorry about that, Guinevere, but thank you. Thank you. Okay, gotta go defeat, you know, Jack's man. See ya. I'm gonna die to this and rise and cross that lake and become one who sees with the eyes of God. You gotta serve him. Same story, told differently, you know. And then the third most popular symbol is the Merkaba. The dreidel is the Merkaba, kind of. The Merkaba is a 3D Star of David. You know, you're the Star of David. Put your arms out, put your legs out. There you go, Star of David. There's the Star of David exercise. Go stand outside barefooted. If you're low on energy, you know, and you've still got lots to do, go outside, put your feet on the ground, not in your shoes, on your feet, and just stand with your, like you're going to do a jumping jack. That's the Star of David. And just stand there, and about 30 seconds, you'll start swaying. And you're literally pulling energy from all around you, from the earth and the air all around you, back into you. You'll feel great. Only takes a minute or two. It's wonderful. You know, you are one with it all. But you're the baby. You know, so certain things are going to happen that you just have to figure, you know, God is great. God is good always. Somehow that's bringing me my good. You know, and the others can see it as, oh, woe is to the world. And let me cry for the world. And let me help the world. And, you know, whatever. It's really about living life. When you're in this body, this life, it's not that long. So wake up each day rejoicing in being alive. This is the lesson from the Ural Steppe people that Dr. Murphy went and visited. It's been documented by other scientists. You know, they generally live to be 125 to 150 years old. Okay, they don't listen to all the caca. They don't have the radios and TVs and all that other shit. You know, we are so busy putting names to everything and becoming aware of everything. You know, that sooner or later, it's your head's full. You gotta empty it. And they're just like, nah, we're just gonna drink our vodka and smoke our cigarettes and eat this pig and work in our garden and eat some veg and have a good night's sleep. It's all good. It depends on how you look at it. So, you know, these three symbols are important to kind of look at in where you are in the story. It's, you know, people are just loving dragons. And that's what we're becoming. One, you know, a dragon. And the question in the Bible has always been, are you going to be a son of man? You're going to be a dragon that burns everybody up and burns yourself up too, you know? Or are you going to be, you know, a dragon that pulls it all together and everyone's safe and secure and, you know, in the arms of the dragon because it's driven by love? Which way are you going to be driven? By fear or by love? You know? And it's really a wonderful choice. You know, the free will is your choice, faith or doubt. Are you going to believe the outside or are you going to believe the inside? Are you going to believe what others tell you or are you going to believe yourself? You know? It's really that simple. And you believe and trust in yourself. So you were doing this with a passion before you were led to these laws. Just do it with the laws, with the same passion. And it comes to be rather quickly. The more feeling, the more passion, the more emotion, the more you stir that energy up. And that's the Merkaba. The Merkaba spins, it's the dreidel, you know, and it's all spinning. It's a vortex, okay? The Holy Grail. Drink the imagination and the dragon. You know, learning to train your dragon. Learning to train our dragon through our imaginations and becoming one in a Merkaba. Isn't that cool? Everything is a symbol. That's why we love symbols. But you can get lost in symbols. That's symbolism. That's the Dan Brown side. That's, you know, it's fascinating. But you get lost in the symbols. You know, yes, it means male and female. But there is no male or female. They're one. You know? It's one being playing the parts that have split. Okay? And if you don't want to accept you're a woman, you're a man, that's great. Do it. Go ahead. It doesn't matter. You have to love it. Love yourself as yourself. Everything you need will come to you to be that. It may be spontaneous, like spontaneous combustion. Who knows? Or maybe it's going to be you get a bunch of money so you can have that operation, whatever. You know, the idea is to just be satisfied and full, content, no hunger, you know. And you don't care about that. I don't care about the money. I don't care about the outside world. I don't care. I care that all are in unity, harmony, and love in my home. And that I see everyone that I have brought these beliefs and thoughts to life in a new way, and I'm going to die every day until I know everyone's filled. They're all filled. And since we're all aware of everyone and everything in the world, I got to go to the top. Because otherwise, I'm always digging in the details and it's tiring. Okay, so everybody is prosperous and abundant and rich and fulfilled. They're beautiful, all of them. They're all babies, my babies, the babies I made with God as Rita. Imagining all these things. Now I release God in all of them. And they're just beautiful. They're alive. God is life. God is love. Love manifests itself here as life. And the feeling you get when you look at life is love. It's this 8 going on. It's the dragon. So I hope this helps. Just my 2 cents, of course. Blessings to you. Thank you. Thank you for being you.
This bank isn't to fall into the hands of the American army.
Sergeant, this bank's not gonna fall in the hands of the American army. It's gonna fall in our hands. You see, we're just a private enterprise operation.
You, the American army?
No, baby, we ain't. You know what's inside that bank, man? There's $16 million worth of gold in that bank, sweetheart.
It's about 65 million marks.
And Sergeant, all you have to do to have an equal share of this money is crank this turret around and blow a hole in that door.